I'll start from my initial days when I left an ID, when I graduated from an ID and then moved on to my own city. Ranchi is a small place in Jharkhand, or the capital of Jharkhand. I started my career with working with RDCIS, SAIL, it's R&D Center for Steel Authority of India Limited, wherein I happened to meet, you know, a group of scientists who were developing some instruments, some machines, which are import substituted and very expensive. So working with them, I realized that, you know, the technology what is there to be developed and maybe what is available is very easy, can be easily converted to a marketable product which they themselves are not able to convert it. Me being a designer with a mechanical engineering background have helped them to design some five instruments and machines which are patented by, they got Indian patent, and they were import substitute devices which are now been taken by Steel Authority and India Limited, and the technology has been transferred to some manufacturer in India. So that was a good start point for me. Almost I worked for three and a half years, and then I got a prestigious Hindu Hitachi scholarship, and I went to Japan Hitachi Limited for 6 months advanced training product design. I was there for almost 6 months and working with their team of designers, and I designed a vacuum cleaner for them. And this process, I understood what they are actually doing it, you know, the way their process and what I learned in an ID. So after that, I returned back in 1999, and then after a year more working in Ranchi, I got a job in Despina Designs. Worked with Mr. Anuj Prashad for almost 5 years and done a lot of product for Whirlpool, LG Electronics, a lot of white goods. And that was a good experience of designing a lot of appliances for this MNC's companies and all, which were mostly aesthetic driven. And then back in the mind was like my experience working with SAIL R&D, which was more overpowering. And with the thought ki maybe I should start something of my own and have my own products, I decided ki let's choose what my own interest area is like. Then I decided to quit and then started my own firm in 2005 with the name of SKM Designs Private Limited. And then I started again writing to those similar kind of R&D companies, like organizations like Terry, like Bhava Atomic Research Center, like Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, like National Metallurgical Laboratories, like, you know, all these kind of organizations. But I rarely get any replies from all these people, because designers are not actually required, and one need to really tell them why I am writing to them. So in that process, I met Terry, you know, first, and then they realized that of course there could be a potential of designing some product. And one of the directors, Dr. Samir Mathal, who actually invited me to design a biomass gasifier, you know. So that was the first experience, and they saw the results is very good. Then I happened to meet the chief controller of R&D. And then he was actually showing some presentation somewhere, showing several kinds of products developed by defense research laboratories. I said, "Kid, these products are good, but only thing, they are not packaged well. Why don't we package well?" And then I was invited to one of the defense organizations, DRDO laboratories, and then started with a small assignment of designing a package for them. That package took me almost like 1 year, because being a government organization, everything has got a process and all, a long process of getting an indent, like getting a purchase order, getting the payment, getting the work done and all such things. But I never lost hope, and I said, things will, let's move, it will move slowly, but one day it will really come to a big thing to me. And of course, So the journey was quite good. I think till now, as of now, I am working on almost like, you know, 7 to 8 defense products, and they're all doing good. They are like, you know, these kits which I developed for defense are actually accepted by Ministry of Defense, going to all three wings of defense on a huge number. All the old designs and the products are being replaced by the new designs, you know. And there is huge quantity orders are, you know, started coming into place. I like technology. I like really, I'm fascinated with technology, and then convert that technology into a marketable product. It could be not one product, it could be a set of products, it could be several products. And the way I perceive things is are quite different, you know. And I know what kind of pains I have taken in this kind of a journey. Not everywhere I get kind of results. I have to really slog a lot to reach the end level. Like I can tell you an example with, you know, the product I done in Ranchi, mechanical instruments, that took almost 4 years to develop. But then that instrument was imported at the cost of 8 lakhs rupees per instrument, and I developed it on a 2 lakhs rupees per instrument. And actually my manufacturing cost is just 1/10 of it, you know. But there is a huge saving of the cost. I took that 4 years of pain, and now my brother who got the technology, he is actually making that product and selling it in the market, and he is the only sole manufacturer of this product in the market in India. Working with small scale industries is a bit challenge as of now, because not many people would be exposed to industrial design, what industrial design is like. But nowadays people have started knowing, I mean, achhe products and they are looking for good products and all. So like a company like Whirlpool, they already have their dedicated team for designers. Things are much easier to work it out. They understand my language very well. But to the small scale industry, I have to educate them first. Yeah? I have to show them the, you know, examples of design, see what they are currently making it and what could be the new one. What the currently making manufacturing process and what could be the new processes. What are the old costs, what are the new costs and all. You know? So once you show them something, they get excited. They get excited. Like the product which I done for Samalkha cluster, actually their products product cost is something like 3,500 rupees. And when I showed them my product on a cheaper price, a better design, they got excited. Now they are ready to invest into basically design and the development process and everything. You know, so this is the kind of things that is different. Microscope is a very, very technical product, very challenging one, very less scope of actually styling. But then there has to be, the product has to be different, because Leica and Jazz and all these people are coming with many new products and all, and I mean they have to be, you know, with the market. So my role here was basically to design the aesthetics, you know, new covers, starting with a sketch and a 3D CAD model, and within that very tight constraints, and then seeing that, you know, everything comes out, if it houses all the components together, and the style is again very subtle, not very jazzy, you know. So this kind of thing which are done, so this will end up with a kind of a puff model and a render, you know. And then, of course, the technical drawings will be taken care by the in-house team of the LabMed, which actually a microscope will have around 300 to 400 components. So I won't be actually knowing most of the components. So I'll just do the major part of work, like styling, and then hand over to the engineering team of the in-house. Initially, when I started working with them, it took around about a month to design a microscope. And not in a stretch, like in a 4 days working in a week and then next 2 days and 4 days like that. And it will take some time, but when I really used to it, designing it, so I remember the last microscope I did actually for done within a 2 or 3 days time. Sketching was done, and another say 3 days time the 3D CAD model was done, and another say 2 days, 3 days puff model was done, my work was over. So 10 days it took end to end to my work, and rest of the process, the CAD would take typically around say 1.5 to 2 months time, and the SLA prototyping, which will usually get it done from China or Taiwan, that will take around typically around two weeks time. So the product end to end may take around 3 to 4 months or maybe 5 months to get launched. I think level, but I think I have done almost all the products for them, and they have involved me for the very beginning when I started my company. They involved me at the very beginning that you, for every project, for every small component also, I have to be there, because that component has to be, it has to gel with the rest of the aesthetics. So I have to be there and assist them. So I'm kind of an integral part of them. You know, very, very, we work very close to each other, you know, not like a client and designer relationship. It's more like, you know, kind of maybe employee relationship, you know, that way we work. It's a very good experience. I think not only here in Leverwood, but all of the places, whatever I am working on, this new innovative areas has been always very inspiring. You know? And as of now, right, I am working, you know, very small team. You know? I am the only designer who actually designed. Then I have a CAD person on a part-time basis, and then other people who just assist me, and then we have the, you know, designs ready. There are opportunities, I think, everywhere. Like in India, if you ask me personally, there's plenty of opportunity in all the sectors and all, you know. Like if you ask me, if you go to take railways, like in one example, I think hardly any designer is working there. It's like massive system, you know, massive system, and actually not few designers, maybe hundreds of designers are required to work in one sector. Like in energy, like non-renewable energy and all, like all the sectors, like transportations, there's huge potential. Only thing, one has to identify what are his like likings and all, that is most important. And of course, if someone is innovative, you know, I want to take the pain that, you know, an area which is not explored, there could be a tremendous market, you know. Like the area I work in, like in a research and development for DRDS and all, very few people work, very few organizations work there. I know there are many challenges and I have to overcome that, but still, if it worked out well, I mean, it's really good.